Thank you for allowing us to share some of our thoughts on the and ideas and the institutional arrangements for geospatial information management in Puerto Rico. Through this 5-minute challenge, we will try to speak about our geography, relevant statistics, some government and institutional arrangements for geospatial information management. Puerto Rico is an archipelago. We have 3 inhabited islands, a population of 3.7 million, and most of the population and the economic activity and critical infrastructure is located in the coastal zone, 44 coastal municipalities. We have 6 ecological life zones and a very narrow insular shelf on the northern coast and a wider insular shelf on the southern coast and in between islands. And most of our shallow reefs and associated benthic communities are mapped. And also we have a network of marine protected areas that comprises about 27.2% of the territorial waters are also mapped. That's information of importance that we could pledge to the development of the Caribbean Marine Atlas. Regarding GIS technology, it's widely used in Puerto Rico, both the ESRI products as well as the open source. That's good. On the governmental side, federal, commonwealth, and municipal governments, as well as the private sector and the academia, collect, use, and publish georeferred data and information. That's not so good in some cases. Some over 250 data layers or GIS layers have been compiled. About 60% have good metadata. So a lot of that 40% is not that good to have going around. So because general public have access to view, use, and download most of the data and information, all federally funded projects are required to share the data. So there is a huge proliferation of data viewers, web atlases, and that's becoming an increasing problem to try to handle conflicting information coming from different government agencies or local county level governments. Some good sources of information, and I know that our colleagues from NOAA are going to be speaking after me, I think that this is a good site to take a look at, the Digital Coast site, Coastal Services Center, the Environmental Protection Agency Region 2 GIS data system 2 is available online. The U.S. Geological Survey has relevant data and information that could be of use for the CMA development. On the Puerto Rico side, the Puerto Rico Planning Board has cadastral information. All permits are geolocated there, and the fields are available to be viewed by the public. The Caribbean Landscape Conservation Cooperative is an awesome online atlas that you can take a look at. It's got species richness, information, landscapes, habitats, mostly terrestrial, but it has like sea turtles and manatees and other marine mammals information available. The Puerto Rico Seismic Network, it's got the buoys and early warning system, information systems is available also online. From our Coastal Zone Management Program Unit, we also have the Puerto Rico side of the Caribbean Regional Ocean Partnership that was established in 2012 in coordination with the U.S. Virgin Islands. And we're developing a marine planner that's gonna be online before the year ends. Over 140 layers of QAQC layers are gonna be loaded there. And also a participatory mapping conducted with the nautical community, fishermen, recreational users are going to be also made available through that. The Puerto Rico Climate Change Council, also coordinated from our office, is a community of over 170 scientists, planners, economists, lawyers, and communicators that have voluntarily provided information, and we produce what is a mandate of ours, the State of the Climate Report an assessment of socio-ecological vulnerabilities 2010-2013, and we're going to be producing that every 3 years. That's got geophysical and chemical information, mostly coastal and marine ecology and biodiversity, as well as socioeconomics. I would say the socioeconomics is a weaker portion of our report. And then the Caribbean Coastal and Ocean Observing System, housed at the University of Puerto Rico Department of Marine Sciences, is an awesome site to access in near real-time waves, currents, and ocean chemistry information. I'm not going to go through this, but that's kind of the standards that we use to collect the information, Federal Geographic Data Committee standards. The datums, recently we finalized the vertical datum, the Puerto Rico vertical datum 2002, that has enabled us to get a bathymetry to coastal relief and seamless mesh that enables us to, using ATSERC, SWAN, and cold wave models, produce very reliable coastal inundation maximums that we can use to conduct evaluations of potential effects and impacts of sea level rise on coastal communities, critical infrastructure, as well as in coastal habitats. This is an example of how, from the regional level, we can also import information that is of use for us at the local level. This is Dr. Steve Shields of the Nature Conservancy, a map on coral larval connectivity. Using the coral distribution maps and using, you know, spawning sites, they are able to use currents. For example, in Puerto Rico, spawning occurs typically during full moons of August, September, and sometimes in October. We're able to correlate that, and using our shallow reefs and benthic communities areas, we are able to, you know, kind of correlate that and monitor that, monitor recruitment and see how our reefs are doing. Regarding, I took a look at the Ocean Health Index. We're at 62, so we're not doing so well. So I hope we can improve this through management, and we are obviously highly committed to the development of the Coastal Marine Atlas. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. I will shift to one question.